Good day, mate. Welcome back to the channel. My name's FPL Roo, and welcome back to another FPL video. So in today's video, we're doing something a little bit different. I've seen a lot of people message me on Twitter to ask what certain words mean, some FPL jargon, you could call it. And I've put out a poll on Twitter to see what some people's favorite is. And then basically in this video, I'm just going to go through some of the top ones and talk about what they are, give some examples. And for anyone that's out there that's ever wondered what these certain FPL specific words mean, maybe your favorite content creator is talking about them, maybe your favorite person you follow on Twitter is talking about them, and you don't actually know what they mean, this video is perfect for you, so definitely keep watching. If you are new, please subscribe to the channel, smash a like on this video too, and leave a comment below. What is your favorite FPL jargon word? Let's get into it.
Yo, listen up, bro, it's stepping up to game, where fantasy Premier League runs in his veins. From transfers to captains, he's always on top, guiding you through every game week nonstop. They say Roo got that Salah flow. Welcome to the channel, enjoy the show. Wild cards, free hits with so much vibe. If you're hunting for success, then make sure you subscribe.
So we'll start with one that is often used around Sunday night, Monday night, after all the Premier League games are finished. It's called knee jerk. So basically it means going early on a player because of a recent haul. So for example, if Sterling, he did score 19 points in a game earlier on this season, everyone knee jerked him in, got him in the team because of that haul. There was no kind of thought process behind that. It wasn't because he had great fixtures, or it was part of that, but it wasn't because it was planned. It was a knee-jerk thing, so it was off the cuff. It was because of the haul. It was kind of jumping the gun too early because of one moment or one game. So that is a big knee-jerk, Raheem Sterling in that game week. And basically, yeah, knee-jerk means just moving on something really, really early, where it could be a trap or it could be a player that's not actually going to do well. It's just a one-off week. Let's get into the next one. So next up, we have flagged. So this is talk about an injured player or when a player might miss a game. So when a player is flagged, they may miss a game. It's normally 25%, 50%, 75% chance of missing that game. A player could also be flagged for being suspended too. It just means they're going to miss a game. For example, Saka is flagged for the next game week, so he might not play. That means that he's either injured or he's got something wrong that either he can't play next game week. So definitely keep an eye on that in your team. If a player is flagged, just click the I button and it'll tell you what percentage chance they will play that game, and it will say why too. So that's yeah, that's flagged. So an asset's basically just an FPL player, but typically a good one. It can be a bad asset, but typically a good one. For example, Son is a great asset. Now he's playing up front. It's normally got a reason why they're a great asset. So Son has obviously moved up front. Now Harry Kane is gone out of the team, so it makes him a much better asset over maybe Richarlison, who's playing off the left. So yeah, asset just basically means player. The next one is dead ending. So this is not a real common one, but it's often used around the wildcard time when people are thinking to use their wildcard. So it's basically used only when planning transfers to specific to a specific week, and then wildcarding. So you're dead ending your team basically into game week 10, and then you're wildcarding. A lot of people use this as basically you're getting the players in up until that period. You're not thinking about anything after that period. Your team after that period is going to be absolutely shocking. That's why it's called dead end, as there's no way out of that. You've got to turn around and do a U-turn or play your wild card, basically. So this one is a funny one, as I'm not really a stats guy, but XNPGI. So it basically means expected non-penalty goal involvements. So there's a thing called XGI, which is expected goal involvement. So it collaborates the goals or an assist in terms of goal involvements. Expected non-penalty goal involvements means penalties are not counted to the expected goals, because an expected goal of a penalty is going to be really, really high because it's a penalty, but it doesn't take into consideration penalties. So this is probably a stat you're going to want to look at rather than looking at just XGI, as got penalties do kind of skew that data. For example, is he's good, but his expected penalties, expected non-penalty goal involvements is not great as he's on penalties. So it's basically to take into consideration that this player's goal involvement, expected goal involvement, is really, really high because he's on penalties and he's had a lot of penalties this season. Celestia XNPGI. So next up is nailed. So it's not a hammer and nails. It's actually when a player is going to start almost every game. You don't need to worry about him. When that team sheet comes out, you know he's going to play. He's absolutely nailed. For example, is I'd rather have Madison over Foden, as Madison is more nailed than Foden. He's more likely to start with Pep. You know, he changes his team like anything. And Foden might not be nailed at that time. So yeah, nailed is a player that's definitely going to start or most likely to start. So next up is lock. So this is often used when a player or team or transfer is set for the game week and won't be changed. So if you are on a wild card and you have, cash is definitely a lock on the wild card. That means cash is a player that you're definitely bringing in. There's no chance that you're going to take him out. There's no chance he's not going to be in your wild card. So you'd say he's a lock. Or if you'd say, yep, my team's locked, my chances are locked, it means you've done that transfer, you've locked that team, and you're not going to be making any other transfers. So, for example, if you're ending the game week and you're saying, transfer's locked, team locked, good luck for the game week, that means you're making no other changes. The next up, we have Enabler. So Enabler is basically a cheap player that allows you to get a more expensive player. So in FPL, we have this thing called Premium. So the Salah, Haaland, Kane at the time, De Bruyne, they're big hitters. So they're big Premium players that cost a lot. But to be able to afford these players, you need some cheap enablers. So some cheaper players that allow you to get in the better players, get in the big players. For example, Gordon is a great enabler as he allows me to get Salah. So Gordon might not be the best midfielder out there, but for his price, he's a great option and he does let me get Salah. So for example, you're going to be comparing Gordon and Salah compared to basically two cheaper options of, say, Madison and Martinelli. So yeah, Gordon is the enabler. Next up is WeMove. So this is typically used when you've had a bad game week or made a bad transfer but want to forget about it. So for example, I dropped 500k rank, but WeMove. So let's forget about it. Let's move on to the next game week. Yeah, basically let's forget about that last game week, WeMove. So the final one is no-brainer. So basically, it's a decision that is so, so obvious that you don't need to think about it. So you'd say captaining Haaland against Luton at home is a no-brainer. Don't even try and think of another decision. Don't even think of another captain. There's no point. Haaland is the choice. There's no other one clear to Haaland. So it's a no-brainer to captain Haaland that week. That was it for the Jargon Busters. Please let me know what you think in the comments below. Smash a like on this video too, as it really does help me out. And subscribe to the channel if you are new. And yeah, leave a comment below. What is your favorite Jargon Buster? Cheers.